Hello and welcome to the second video in this series on how you can write your own programs for the class Pet2 in C. In this video, we will install the cross compiler and the Hollyhock SDK. I will put a link to this to all things that we will need in the video description. First, we need to download two things: binutils. There will be a link. Click on this link. Scroll down, obtaining binutils. Click this link and just download the newest version, which I think is this. We can download as an XZ file or as a GZ file. I will choose the GZ file. Save file. We are in documents. Just remember where you put it, and then we will need GCC. Click on the next link. Download mirrors. I will choose this one in Germany. Click on releases and scroll down to the latest release, which is this one, and download the gzip archive and save it to the same folder. So now we can go to the Linux. We can open our Linux terminal. I'm using, because I'm on Windows, I will use Windows subsystem for Linux, but if you're using Ubuntu, just use your normal Ubuntu terminal, whatever you use. We need to run these commands. Copy and paste. If you want to paste, you can. Wait, that's the wrong one. When you want to copy, you can hit Control C. But if you want to paste, you have to hit Control Shift V, or you can use right click. The first line. The second line. And the third line. Just hit enter after every line. This will create a few variables that are used later. Now we have to download binutils. That's what we just did. So we change into the folder. Because I've created these links, I can just, in the first video, we can just do this. If we wouldn't have done this, we would have to do it this mount C documents and settings, but because I have made the links, we can just use the downloads W folder, which is the Windows downloads folder. I think I've called it YouTube video without the O. Now we are in the directory where we have these two files. First, we will unzip the binutils. To do that, type in tar-extract verbose zip file binutils. This will extract the archive. This shouldn't take that long, and when it is done, we have to execute the command make dir build. This will create a folder called build. We have to change into that folder, and then we have to run this command. This will create a make file, so we can just run make, and then we have to run make install. This will install binutils. So the extracting should be done in a few seconds. Can I pause it? So this took around 5 minutes. Now we've unpacked this. Now we change directory into this folder that we've just extracted. If we list this, that's what's inside. So we make a directory called build, and then we cd into this directory, and then we run this command. Copy with Ctrl C and right click to paste. This will create a make file so we can compile the compiler. Just copy, no, that was the wrong one. Just copy this and run make. This will take a few minutes, so I will pause the video again. So that took a few minutes. The last command we executed was make, which compiled binutils. So now we have to make install. Now we have to make install. And this will install the cross compiler we just built. This should really not take that long. I was right, that didn't take very long, but longer than I expected. Now we have binutils installed. We can see this if we type sh4elf. If we hit tab, we have now these programs installed, the assembler and the linker. We will need that later. We install GCC. For this, we change directory back out of build, back out of binutils. If I list the files we have in this directory, this was binutils, which we downloaded and extracted into this. Inside this, we compiled it and installed it. Now we have to do the same with this. First, we need to extract this. To do this, type tar-extract verbose zip file gcc. Just hit tab to autocomplete and hit enter. This will take a few seconds, so I will pause the video. So the unpacking is done. If my keyboard will turn back on and I can type in list. We have now the folder GCC. We change directory into this folder. There is stuff that we have extracted in this folder. We are now here. I think we first have to run this. This will download something and then we have to run the next call. So it shows our everything was downloaded. Now we can copy this, Ctrl C, right click, and then we can change directory into this, and then we can run this. Ctrl C, right click. This will create a make file. And then we can run this. This will actually take a while, so I will stop the recording for a moment. So, this took longer than I expected, and because Windows decided to switch from my main microphone to a microphone on my headphone that's somewhere in the back, I don't have the audio. If anything should crash, just run the three export commands at the beginning. So the last command we run was make all GCC. So the next command I will run now is make all target libgcc. Once again, just copy this command and paste it into the terminal. Oh, why am I scrolling up and down in the recording? Yes, just copy this next command, copy and into the terminal and paste. You can use Ctrl Shift V to paste, or you can use right click to paste. I think I didn't hit copy. So once again, select it, copy, go into the terminal, Ctrl Shift V to paste, and then click enter to run, do this. And I will stop the recording once again. Now this is compiled, and now we have to install both things, GCC and target libgcc. To do this, run the next command, sudo make install gcc. Sudo means that it is run as root, so with more privileges. So just paste this in, hit enter, and then type in your password. I think I made a cut in the video at this point because I didn't want you to know my password. So, yes, just type in your normal Windows password. And then it should install the GCC cross compiler. And then when it's done, go back and copy the next line, which is install target libgcc. So just copy and then paste it into the terminal and click enter, and once again just type in your password. If you're using Windows subsystem for Linux, this is just your regular Windows password. And by the way, you won't see it while you're typing it. You won't even see something like stars, just nothing. Just type it in correctly, I guess. So when you've done that, you've installed the compiler. And now I would recommend adding this line to your bashrc file. You can use whatever text editor you want to edit the bashrc file. First, you can type cd and this thing to go back to your home Linux home directory. And I would use y to edit bashrc. But if you want, you can use any other text editor like Nano. In this example, I'm using Nano. Some people say that Nano is easier to use. I think Y is easier to use, but just use whatever you want. Type in the name of your text editor. In this case, Nano. That's usually pre-installed, and then you then type .bashrc, and then scroll down to the bottom. Use the arrow keys, and then just type in this line. I think you can even paste it. Yes, that's what I did. This will tell Bash every time you start it again. Hit Control O to write and Control X to exit if you're using Nano. This line that we've added to bashrc will tell Bash every time we start a terminal where to find the compiler. Okay, I think that was everything for this video. We can actually test if
We have installed it correctly. If you type sh4 and then hit tab, it should list you all the sh4 cross-compiler and cross-assembler stuff. Yes, that was everything for this video. I will see you in the next video. Bye!